I'm Elsie Cameron. I'm a professor at the Federal University of State of Rio de Janeiro and a PI of the Laboratory of Protein Biochemistry. My lab is a core lab in mass spectrometry at the university, so we are doing different things, but my main interest is about sportomics. In this approach, we are trying to understand the omics sciences related to what happened in response to exercise, but real exercise that happens during sports events. Meaning we don't bring the athletes to the lab in order to study them, but other than that, what we do is to bring the lab to the athletes to study what exercise causes in their metabolism in the real way, in the real field of action when the athletes are training or competing. The first challenge is to take out the samples. So after that, we have different processes because we need to analyze cell lines, and when we do that, we do it whole blood. We work with serum, we work with plasma, and then we need to prepare the samples in order to put in different machines, not just mass specs, but also other machines in order to understand what's going on with the samples. I choose to move to mass spec because I think that mass spec is the ultimate technique, at least from in these days, that we can use to have a huge amount of data regarding metabolomics and proteomics. I have a personal link with Synaptic because I like to use non-targeting analysis in order to understand what's going on in response to sports and exercise. And Synaptic gives me the opportunity of doing that using iMobility. And then I can understand much better the proteomic and metabolomic difference. Regarding the future, I would say that the problem that we have is that we are dealing with a lot of innovation. I really believe that sportomics is a kind of bridge between what we are learning and personalized medicines. We have to use cutting-edge technology, cutting-edge equipment, and not just that, we need to innovate regarding the process. We need to create process. That's one thing that makes me very happy to be a center of innovation, because we can share our needs with scientists from other centers of innovation and also with water scientists. And it's making my life much more easier. Regarding that, I would say that the biggest challenge is to bring to reality these machines that needs to be used in a way that they will never be used before.